بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. النهارده المفروض ان احنا هنبتدي في بارت 2 اللي هو سولفنج ايه ذا بروبلم. واحنا زي ما احنا متعودين ان كل بارت متقسم الى مجموعه من الاوبجكتيفز، زي ادي دي الاوبجكتيفز المقرر علينا في بارت 2: gather and analyze data, develop alternative, evaluate options, implement the solution and develop what ethical solution. زي ما احنا متعودين كل اوبجكتيف هيبقى له مقدمه صغيره ومجموعه من الجايد لاينز. ماشي. فالاوبجكتيف ده اللي هو جاذرنج انالايزنج ايه داتا، بقول زي ما احنا متعودين ايه له مقدمه كده صغيره. يعني هو كل البارت ده الغرض منه شوز ذا مانجنج اوكي ذا ميثودولوجي اوف سولفنج problems. ماشي. ودي يعني ادي الكلمتين دول عباره عن مقدمه صغيره قوي لبارت 2. لما نيجي في الاوبجكتيف الخاص ب gathering and analyzing data، ماشي، احنا اول اوبجكتيف اللي هو ايه gathering and analyzing data، ده اول اوبجكتيف. اوكي، هو كاتب هنا ايه؟ بيقول before you can solve a business problem you should gather what you should gather relevant data and analyze it. المقصود هنا بكلمة relevant اللي هي ايه؟ مرتبطة. يعني زي ما ادينا دايما مثال، لو انا if I have a problem for reduction of sales we have to go for some relevant data. I mean should be relevant such as something like the evolution of this reduction, the region, the product, the amount, the rate of that reduction. This is what we call it relevant what data, right? Successful business decisions are based on sound information, important information, critical information, okay, to systematically gather and analyze the data related to your problem. Start by identifying your goal. Actually, for the first part, we have to identify what we are looking for. I mean, what will be the end? What will be the objective? What will be the goal? We have in this part or in this gathering and analyzing data, we have to determine that, specify that to collect what the required information, right? So now we go for, the guidelines for gathering data and as we get used about this course. So in each objective we have a little or small or brief introduction and some guidelines for this objective. The first guideline, which is define your data needs. The same story, we have to identify only the required needs. Here means what required, the required data, and we have to prepare a list about the most important data. We have to determine their or its sources. So what information, we have to collect or we have to collect according to our needs and their resources. In this point also for defining your data needs, we have to consider or put in your consideration as a decision maker or problem solver, you have to consider the cost of this information. And this cost could be determined as time or what money. Okay. And we have to collect only data or determine the only data that give you the best return about or from your what your effort. The second guideline, do not overestimate what you know about the problem. Do not overestimate what you know about the problem. In this guideline, he mentioned, or he wants to show you, that you have to be scientific and objective, and you have to be open-minded, okay? You have to be open-minded. Do not make too much, or you cannot say, I know everything. You cannot say that. I know everything. What you know about the problem is still some information you need. For the third guideline, document the data and its sources. Document the data and its sources. You have to record. You have to record the basic information, who gave it to you, when, location. This guideline is very important when you go and make some sort of review about information. Okay, again, document the data. You have to write the data you collect and its resources as reference. As reference, you can go later and review about who said that, when, and location. I mean, location here means maybe from different departments or different regions or different divisions, whatever, right? The fourth guideline, he said, what? Examine existing information first. Examine existing information first. And the critical word here, the key word here, information first. Because he said here that acquiring information actually costs you some money, right? So before you spend that money, you have to go and review the current information. The current information, the actual information. And you can get this information from organization records, reports. Always they have good enough information. You can use it easily and quickly before you go for another or outside information. So in this guideline, he wants you to check first the existing, the actual, the current information. Otherwise, maybe you will cost unnecessary money. For the rely on people as your most important resource, in this guideline, he wants to focus on the individuals or people, that always people, they have information. Okay, always people, they have some available information. People who are experienced, they have some sort of experience. Okay, people who are very related to the problem, directly or indirectly. Okay, especially a lot of people, or a lot of individuals, or a lot of people, they are always willing to participate. So here he said, what? Rely on people as your most important what? Resource. Okay. The final guideline, or the last guideline, he said, what? Consider interrelationship. Consider interrelationship. Okay. Always, when you go for some problems, you find that they have some sort of interrelationship with different areas. And actually, for example, always we have some sort of conflict between production people and the marketing people. They always have some sort of conflict. Marketing people, they want a lot of products, a lot of diversity of products. Production people, they want something like very simple products. Number of diversity is very little. So always we have some sort of conflict between marketing and production people. So we have to go and collect the data about the interrelationships between these two parties, between marketing and production, okay? For the second objective here, which is developing alternatives. He said what? After researching a problem and collecting data, start to consider alternatives and solutions. This creative phase. The key word here that in this objective or in this step, it is what conceptual phase. It is conceptual step. This is creative phase of the process required, and it requires what? It requires imagination and intuition, because here you can generate some alternatives, some options, some scenarios, some different solutions. So it depends on your imagination and intuition, in your as a decision maker or problem what solver. Okay, so in this objective, you have to generate many alternatives and ideas, and also some hint here that you have to ask people who are close to the problem. Right? And as we said before, for each objective, this is its introduction, and we have to. Okay. In this evaluating options, we have to go for some guidelines, okay? Some guidelines such as choose an evaluation method. I mean, now you are in a stage of, you have an option, you have an alternative, and you want to evaluate it, you want to judge it. The easy thing you have to go for, how can, or what is the method, or what is the approach to evaluate, okay? The easy one, you go for pros and cons of each alternative. I mean, the positive aspects, you go for each alternative, and something like advantages and disadvantages, negative aspects and positive aspects for each what option or for each what scenario. Okay, for the second guideline, he said what? Select the criteria, select the standard, okay? I mean, how can we evaluate this option? You have to go for criteria such as it is suitable for the problem or suitable for the organization, it has time, it has its own cost, it has its own profit, okay? So you go for this criteria. I mean, I could go and compare between options or among options according to some sort of criteria. Suppose you want to, you have some options about buying a laptop. When you go and buy a laptop, you have to put or you put or establish some criteria in which you have to go and compare among them, among options or among alternatives. Something like weight, something like whatever price, quality. These are criteria. You have to select. When you go and evaluate options, you have to select these criteria. As I said, if you want to go and buy a laptop, so on which basis you have to compare between Dell and HP and Lenovo, on what basis? This basis we call it criteria. Price, I will compare among them according to quality, price, screen, memory, whatever, right? After that, when you go for evaluating options, you have to put some weights. for your criteria, some weights, because all of these criteria, such as cost, time, profit, as I said, weights for the laptop and memory, all of this, all these criteria are not equally important for you. Maybe cost may be more important than whatever, time. Maybe memory is more important than whatever, price, right? So you have to put some weights to declare the relative importance of these criteria, which one is more important than other one, right? So you have also for this step, you have to establish weights for the required or identified criteria. Okay, and after that, you have to rate the alternatives. I mean, you have to put some sort of ranking, some sort of order or ranking this alternative. Okay, actually, as in your management course, just we multiply, mathematically multiply the score and what? And weight, score of each option or each alternative, what for its weight, just to rate or to rank your alternatives, right? The last step in evaluating options, he said, but make a decision. I mean, this evaluation could be not perfect, but in some complex problem, maybe you cannot reach optimality, but you can be comfortable or good enough solution or good enough option or good enough decision, right? So if these steps are what? Steps in evaluation options. You have to, what will be the approach? Okay, approach, pros and cons, positive and negative. Which criteria? Cost, profit, time. Are these criteria the same important or the same importance level? If not, you have to give weights to declare, as I said, to declare the relative importance, and you have to rank the available alternative. This ranking or this rating could be by multiply the weight and score for each what alternative, and you go and pick up the best what alternative. Picking up this alternative in some, as I said, in some complex problems, maybe you cannot reach what optimality, but you can have some sort of enough solution or good enough solution. Now we move for another objective, which is implementing the solution. Okay, and this is, we have some sort of carrying out solution, okay, or carrying out the solution. He said what? Moving from planning to implementation is a significant milestone. Milestone, the basics or the most what important. Moving from planning, all of the previous steps or objectives, they always have some sort of conceptual or theoretical or something without implementation. Now we have to move for implementation. He said that during implementation, you begin to make decisions, take actions, and put your plans into practice. Put your plans into practice. Now you have to prepare for implementing the solution, taking action. Maybe you have to be start with HR required personnel, maybe you have to be ready by assigning budget, okay, and put your plan into what practice. In this objective, he wants to show you that communication is very important. They communicate clearly and frequently during this stage. I mean, they have to have some sort of periodical review, okay? Through what? Through communication. You as a decision maker, you have to communicate with people, as I said, or personnel, who will go and carry out or implement the selected solution or implement the option, or selected option or selected alternative. You have to go and communicate clearly and frequently. I mean frequently, maybe gradually, maybe I mean periodically during what this stage. Okay? Act decisively rather than planning endlessly. In this statement, he wants to show you that you have to go for decisively, okay, acting. Decisively here means what? Insistently, rather than planning endless. I mean, you have to go and start for implementation. Don't go for too much time in planning. I mean, in some cases, they go for too much and spend too much time in planning. And now they get lost about the actual problem, the actual solution. They go for planning, too much planning. He said that no, act decisively, mean importantly, essentially, rather than start to implement, rather than planning what endlessly, right? Without end, it means. Now we can move to, as we get used, about some guidelines for implementing what the solution, some guidelines for implementing a solution. He said about what? Five guidelines. He get what? The first one, get approval from problem owner. Get approval from the problem owner. You remember when we said we have problem owner who affected directly from the solving problem and stakeholder, problem stakeholder, you remember? I mean, stakeholder, all they are affected but indirect. Anyway, he said get approval from the problem what owner. In this guideline, you have to consult. You have to consult the problem owners just to make sure from their support to the required solution or the selected solution, you have to go and discuss, you have to go and explain to them, right? Them, I mean here, the problem owners, okay? The second guideline, he said what? Develop a plan. Develop a plan. He said here, in other words, you have to go and outline steps to apply the selected alternative. Okay? In this case, you have to write a list about the required resources. You have to estimate time for the selected solution. You have to go for timetable for selected solution. You have to expect some results or what will be the situation after solving what the problem. Again, in this guideline, he said what develop a plan. Now you start to actual implementation. You have to outline the steps, required steps, sources, time, I mean timetable, expected results, and what will be the situation after you solve what problem. Another guideline about notify stakeholders. Notify stakeholders. Here, We have to determine or specify the impact of the selected decision or selected option, the impact on everybody inside the organization, what will be, especially for managers. If we implement the solution, what will be the impact on their jobs, their tasks, their performance? Why you do that? Just to make guarantee that the solution or the option or the alternative or the decision will be accepted. As long as you unify stakeholders, and we said before, stakeholders, these are people who affected directly, indirectly, I mean, I'm sorry, indirectly about the solution. You have to inform them, okay? You have to inform them, as I said, to guarantee that the solution will be accepted from them. Another guideline, he said what? Anticipate opposition. Actually, for the solution, maybe some solutions have some sort of a change. And actually, we want to reassure that people will not resist that change. So you have to go and go for explain how can this solution very good to be applied, to be used, okay? Especially solution who can cause some change, as I said. Always we have resistance for any change. So maybe this solution will have some sort of change. So before resistance, you have to go and discuss with people, individual managers, you have to discuss how can this solution will be the best for you, for your organization, for you as a manager, for your performance, for your decision, for your activities, whatever, right? The last guideline for implementing the solution is to take action. I mean, start to take specific actions. Okay, start to take some sort of specific action. Always decision maker suffer from entry. Okay, inertia. This is what means that. Maybe you have some sort of fatigue, some sort of boring. So he said, "What before having that, before this appear, this boring, just you have to take what action. So start to take what specific what action. Otherwise, maybe some." If you are late in taking action, maybe some changes, some resistance, some, as I said, they start to get boring. So actually, once you anticipate opposition, and once you notify stakeholder, start to take specific action. All right, these are guidelines for implementing the solution. Okay. Now we have to go for the final or the last objective is this part about developing ethical solutions. Actually, ethics are standard of behavior that direct how people should act. Actually, we have to develop solution that will not have any harm to anybody. Okay. What do you mean by ethics? Ethics means you have to differentiate between right and wrong, and you go right. Okay? Differentiation between right and wrong, and you go right. If you have that, you are an ethical person. So here he said what? Ethics are a standard of behavior, of course. How can you behave ethically? Okay, that direct how people should what act, because these ethics or these standards of behavior must reflect your actions, must reflect your decisions or your solutions. He said here, ethics involve making moral decisions and choosing between right and wrong. Again, the same meaning. And when you go and apply the problem solving, ethical behavior leads to good enough decisions, not necessarily the optimal ones. Because as I said, in some cases, you cannot reach optimal solution or optimal decision. Okay? Consider situations from an ethical point of view. Consider situations from an ethical. I mean, always when you go and make decision or make solutions or implement solutions, you have to what take care about that. You have to consider in your accounting, you have to consider ethical issues. Okay, so he said here, consider situations from an ethical as well as a practical perspective. Okay, from practical point of view, or from practical point of view, right? So we move to the first guidelines. So thank you very much for listening, and thank you very much for your following me in this part two. Thank you.